sparkling entertainment by Canada Dry, the champagne of ginger ale. Canada Dry is now available in the large as well as the regular size bottle for the home and made to order by the glass at fountain. This program stars Jack Benny, the Canada Dry humorist, and Ted Williams Orchestra. Ted Williams opens the program with Roll Up the Carpet.
Dane Benny, the Earth Galloper, coming to you again with some very late news reports. And are they late? I'll never order from that man again. Anyway, these news gems come to you through the courtesy of the Morning Grapefruit, the news that first to reach your eyes. All the late dispatches by wire, telephone, cable, and cruiser.
All right, Jack, start it.
All right, Paul, don't butt in. This is for our cash customers. All right, let's go. Prosperity note. Hannibal, Missouri. Conditions improving here. Mississippi now running on full time. Washington, D.C. President Hoover spends 2 weeks vacation fishing. He catches an eel, but later finds out it's a shark suffering from the depression. Wander around with that one, folks.
This is Jack Benny talking.
London, England. In economy drive, Prince of Wales sells his horse and will take in the falls at Niagara this year.
Get it?
Moscow, Russia. 5-year plan ends this month. 7-year itch will start immediately. Union Square, New York. Man found beating himself overhead with club. When asked why he was doing this, he said he was a red and missed the last meeting. Winfield Column, New York. Stork seen hanging around Ted Wheel's door.
What stork?
That was a wolf. Oh, pardon me. Venice, Italy. 3 pedestrians cross street against red light and are drowned. Mott Street, Chinatown. War news. 2 Japanese spies found hiding in the dish of chop suey, disguised as mushrooms.
Darn clever, these Jap.
Delhi, India. Big blaze starts in business section of Delhi, burning down several Delhi confectionery stores. That's local. Very local, that. Bombay, India. Mahatma Gandhi puts on a suit of clothes and is mistaken for Kid Crocker. Erie, Pennsylvania. Eclipse just arrived here. No other news. Glasgow, Scotland. 14 cents collected in big relief drive last week. Drivers over and people flocking back to city. Lunch wagon, Ohio. Circus midget commits suicide in restaurant by jumping off a 3-decker sandwich. January 22nd, 1901. Marconi invents wireless. January 22nd, 1933. Marconi hears this program and is sorry he started it. St. Paul, Minnesota. Three skaters break through thin ice and almost drown. Paul, Minnesota. Minnesota.
Oh, I see. You can get a cool drink of Stanley the Dry ginger ale at Minnesota Fountain.
Uh-huh. You think it, Paul. You think it. Well, we both had a reach for those. Play, Ted, play.
Now we're off to this familiar melody. Bing Crosby's theme song, Echo in the Valley.
Cleaning out the closet, and found a manuscript of this masterpiece, which is entitled, Mary, just off the title. Here it is. The name of the play is Bertha the Sewing Machine Girl. Now, this famous old play with a tear, a laugh, a heart throb, a few hisses, and no doubt your money back. However, it was a great success in its day. I might even say as big as Rosie's Irish Race, written by Anne Nichols. Nickels, Paul, nickels.
And you get 5 cents back on each large Canada Dry.
Why, you couldn't say nickels, could you? You couldn't do that, huh? Now, this play, Bertha the Sewing Machine Girl, was a great success in its day, having had such runs as one consecutive night in Perth Amboy, another night at Asbury Park, and then direct to the storehouse where it ran over a year. The members of the original company have been dead for over 35 years, so we have our own all-star cast this evening, which is as good as the cast in Grand Hotel. The members of the original company have been dead for over 35 years, so we have our own all-star cast this evening, which is as good as the cast in Grand Hotel, we think. Of course, what you think is entirely up to you. We have rehearsed faithfully for 5 minutes and will present it to you immediately without the customary break-in out of town. Now, here are some of the original criticisms when the play had its premiere in 1890. Walter Winchell's father. Bertha the Sewing Machine Girl is as fine a play as I've ever looked over a transom at. Ankle over and see it. Ed Sullivan, Sr., Bertha the Sewing Machine Girl will have you in stitches. That wasn't bad. I thought of that myself. George G. Nathan, I saw the play, and as they say in church, you. So now, ladies and gentlemen, we are reviving this play tonight for your pleasure. Remember the title, Bertha the Sewing Machine Girl. And meanwhile, Ted Williams and his boys will play 12th Street Rag, which is very appropriate.
ice cold Canada Dry ginger ale made to order by the glass. This way, right here.
Right this way, madam. Seats 1 and 3 on the ice. Now, ladies and gentlemen, for our dramatic offering, Bertha the Sewing Machine Girl. Curtain, music bed. That's supposed to be a sewing machine, folks. Last week, you used it for an automobile, you know?
Oh, I'm getting sick and tired of this hard work. All I do is work and toil and slave. The sewing machine is driving me mad. Who is it?
It's the landlord.
Come in.
I'm sorry, Miss Higgins, but I came to tell you that I must foreclose the mortgage.
Oh, can't you wait a little longer? Surely you're not going to drive us out in the cold, cold night. What a night.
Hey, a little stronger on the wind, fellas.
What a night.
I've waited long enough. I must have the money in 10 minutes or else I'll foreclose.
Looks like we close at 4.
Remember, 10 minutes. Goodbye.
Oh, what shall I do? What shall I do? Poor old father. He will soon be homeless. It's 3 o'clock and Daddy isn't home yet. Oh, here comes Papa now. Hello, Daddy.
Wait till I come in.
Hello, Daddy.
Hello, babe. Pardon me, I'm sorry. What are you crying about, Messiah?
Oh, I'm so tired of it all. I work hard all day cooking and scrubbing and washing and so on and so on.
So on what?
So on buttons.
All right, Mary, cut out the joke. Who is there?
Clingy,
Clingy, stay out of this sketch, will you?
All right.
Well, daughter, what have we got for supper tonight?
Tonight's roast wolf, Daddy.
Roast wolf. You finally let him in, eh?
I suppose you know that the real estate man is here today.
You tell him we don't want any?
He said he'd give us 10 minutes to pay up or get out.
Leave him.